Hello friends, it's Lisa, and I'm here today to show you how to create your own turnabout stamps. That's how I created the background on these two cards. First, I went into Pages on my Mac, but you can use any program. It's really simple. We're just creating 1-inch squares, so you can totally do this on any of the Microsoft products, as well as the Pages if you have Mac. I just haven't been willing to pay the money to actually get the Microsoft stuff. You have to pay it every year. It's crazy. Anyway, so I did some Googling online and found that 72 points is supposed to equal an inch. I'm not sure if it does or doesn't because I had some issues and we'll see that in a minute. But that's what it says online. So what I'm trying to do is to create a 6-inch grid. Now I'm starting with the first corner because that's what you need is the four corners, because you're going to want to have things, you'll see. But what I'm doing is I have the color of the quadrant and then I have the letters. So I'm able to match it up. I finally figured out how to turn it. You need to rotate it at 90 degrees and rotate that whole quarter as a group. Next, I'm going to change the colors of the squares. But if you can tell, all of the squares rotated perfectly together. So the A is in the same spot every time. So when I rotate the paper, as I'm stamping, the stamps stamp in the right place. It's kind of hard, but as you see what I do, I think it'll make a lot of sense. If you want to create one of these, you can create it on the computer or just go to my blog, and that's down below in the description section, and I'll have a picture of this grid, and you'll be able to create your own. You just want to make sure that you have the quadrants colored, and you can simply highlight it. It doesn't need to be anything fancy, and the letters in exactly the same places that I have them. And then you'll completely be able to do this. So I printed it 3 times. It took me that long to get it the right size, because when I printed it out, instead of being an inch, each square was 3/4 of an inch. So I ended up just making them all the squares 96 points. Or what I really did was I just captured everything and made it a quarter bigger or whatever. I did the math. Anyway, you want each of them to be an inch in size. And that's what this one is. Now, next thing I do is I trim it down 1/4 of an inch on each side. So it's a 6.5 by 6.5 piece of paper. I will also be cutting out another 6.5 by 6.5 square piece of paper that I can attach my card bases to. And you'll see that it's a red piece of paper, just a scrap, because it's going to get a bunch of stamps on it. Now, why did I do this? I did it because I ordered some turnabout stamps by Concord & Knight, and they hadn't gotten here by now. Like, at this point, they hadn't gotten there, and I was just too excited. So I pulled out 2 stamp sets that I thought would work well with this. This one's a Tim Holtz stamp set, and the other one is, it was in one of those crafty magazines, the stamping magazines. So it's a full page sheet, and it has a bunch of travel-y kind of masculine stuff, so I really like it. Now, what you're going to want to do, since you're stamping this 4 times, is you need to stamp 1/4 of the design. That's why I'm placing everything in that one quadrant. Now, some of this stuff layers over onto another quadrant, and that's good because it won't look so boxy. It'll kind of flow together. But you have, since you can't, and I layered the stamps because I want them to kind of stamp on top of each other a little bit. You have to lay it all out in that one quadrant, and then you're going to move it to the other quadrants. This is why getting those letters in exactly the right place is so vitally important, because you want to move all the stamps to exactly on to be exactly on the same letters. Now, I have it all set up, and all I need is my actual card background that I'm going to stamp on. You can stamp this in different colors. That's one of the great thing about those Concord and Ninth is that they really work well when you're stamping them in different colors. But I really wanted to color these with my Copic markers. So I got out the Hero Arts Inktense black ink pad and just stamped everything in that today. So all you do with this stamp platform is you just stamp it down in the first place. And you want to make sure that you have it in the corner every time. I think this is where I messed up and the paper jiggled a little bit and moved. And I tried to stamp it again and it was a little bit off. So don't do what I do. Actually, like, check it and just keep going. At this point, I was a little nervous about this one. The numbers just looked like a big square. It wasn't really what I was going for. One thing I did find is you really have to overlap the stamps. If you think you have enough stamps, put another two on. Especially when they're the small ones. Because see, there's so much open space, it didn't look as good as I wanted it to. So I'm adding these two on, and I'm just gonna go ahead and stamp again. Now, I've left the other things in the right same place. So I'm gonna add this second card background on. And we'll try again. I'm just using repositionable tape. If you have, oh, what's that stuff called? Zyron adhesive remover. That probably would be better than not having one like I do. But I just use the permanent adhesive over it. So all I'm doing again is just stamping down. So this time, instead of getting that big block of numbers, I'm gonna get some fingers pointing out. If you had a different set of stamps, at this point I don't have a whole lot of stamps that would work really well. Here I'm giving you a nice freeze frame that would work really well with this technique, just because I've only been collecting this set of stamps for a few months. And stamps are expensive. So here you can see I'm really loading it a lot more. The hardest part is moving the things from one quadrant to the next quadrant. Like, it's a little difficult and you have to really think about it. So just be aware that's going to take the most amount of time. And that's okay. You want it right because you don't want to be seen being right on top of each other. But you'll see this one turns out a whole lot more full than those first two that I created. I do show you more on these cards, the ones with these travel stamps, but the issue was my Copic coloring didn't turn out great. Like, I didn't pick the right colors, so that was the issue, not that my turnabout stamp abilities. It was my Copic coloring abilities. So you can really make some cool stuff. And if you do this technique, please share it with me because I'd love to see it. I've sped it up a lot because I go real slow. Now, I wanted to fill in even more. So I took some of the tiny stamps from the stamp set. And I thought it would just be easier to stamp them with these small blocks because it doesn't matter if they're perfect or not perfect. since the stamp is, I mean, the background is so busy, they're just kind of going to fit in. I tried to get it so they match the turnabout-y feel of it, but it's easy peasy. Adding some words just kind of get in the background. I think this is a great way to fill in. So if you don't get everything, just add some of those small stamps. All stamp sets have them. See here, I'm trying without this stupid eraser thing, and it's not working. I finally just gave up. I was like, whatever. So I really loved how these ones came out, but there was also a little bit of open space. So just using that one stamp, you do really want to overlap. I know that it seems kind of counterintuitive, but when you're creating a background like this, that's what you really want. So you do get a very center point, but it's able to really highlight where your sentiment should go. It should go in the center. So, because everything kind of revolves around that. Now, I haven't made cards with these travel ones. And you can see the first one I showed looked a little bit better than this one. But what are you gonna do? Sometimes things just don't turn out wonderful. I think I'll just make them as small cards. But I'm still coloring on this one, and so I wanted to show you. Here are the markers I used for both the one I'm about to show you and the other Tim Holtz background. So since the other two, the two travel ones didn't turn out super great, I figured you wouldn't actually care which markers I used, because I didn't, you know, since it didn't turn out, I'm just gonna let you try it with your stamps and with your colors. But you could do some really cool stuff. Use your stamps and stamp them out in different colors, or stamp them on watercolor paper and watercolor over it. There's just so much stuff you could do with this. And it takes that concept that is just so awesome, and it creates, and you're able to use it to create something else that's also awesome. Now, I have another video coming up with the Concord and Knight stuff, so don't think I'm saying, like, those aren't awesome, because I super love everything I got from them, and I really do like the turnabout stamps. But this is also a great way to get that same look and the fun when you want to use it with different stamps, or if you don't have the turnabout stamps. You can totally create backgrounds just like this. So here I was like, those two just didn't come out great. That was honestly about where I was. Now, I just got this new trimmer. I'd been working with my Cricut trimmer that I'd gotten. It was one of the very first things I got after I had my whole issue and restarted my craft room. So what I'm doing is I decided to try this one. It doesn't just have a blade, it has the circular knife, rotary knife. I really liked the rotary knife when I did sewing. I'm not going to do sewing anymore because I just didn't enjoy it, but the rotary tool was so amazing. I was like, oh, it'll be perfect for this. I'm not sure if I haven't gotten the hang of it, or if I need to replace the knife, even though that's literally the first time I ever used it, or if I'm just not pushing hard enough. It could be me. It could be the tool. I'll keep you posted. If it is the tool, I'm going to be slightly upset. I'm hoping that I can fix this. So we'll see. But all I did is cut the paper in half, and of course, my card topper things don't fit perfectly. I literally don't know what I'm doing wrong every time. I had to cut down both of the cards a little bit. I had to take my scissors and just trim some off. It's literally both Nina paper, 80-pound paper. It's literally the same paper from the same paper pack. I cut it in half both times. I don't know. Don't ask me. So when the card base doesn't fit, I just cut it down on the sides. I think that's the easiest thing to do, and it still looks good. So I also put the folded side down and put the card together that way. I feel like I get the most square results. Plus, you can cut the bottom off, but you can't cut that fold off. Now, I'm taking some glitter dust in gold since these are kind of antique looking. I did put some, oh, what is that? The regular Tim Holtz tea dye ink over after I finished Copic coloring. I don't think I said that before, but that's what I did to get the older look. And it really tones down those bright Copic markers that I chose and just really fit in well. I do like the glitter dust. It adds just that nice sheen. I'm trying to figure out which stamp to use. Oh, no, I didn't include that because it took me like 10 minutes to figure out which stamp to use. And I used this Thinking of You stamp because I felt like that was a good, really anytime stamp sentiment. I think I may use this as my Mother's Day card, but I haven't completely decided. We'll see. I also need to send a card to someone else, so I need to send these out. That would probably be good. Anyway, I'm just taking some label dies that I had. I don't remember. I think they're scrapbooking made simple car dies. So, but really any label dies you have are perfectly fine. I don't think you have to have exactly what I have. Use what you have. That's the most important thing. So, I'm just cleaning off my stamp. I clean as I go. So sometimes I cut that out and sometimes I leave it in, but if I don't clean as I go, it becomes a big giant mess. Now I'm taking my Gemini Junior plates and I'm going to send them through my regular sized Gemini machine. The regular sized Gemini machine is really big, so it doesn't really fit on camera very well. So I'm not going to show you that. But it works super amazing. So I put it through and it goes really fast because I'm using the half size plates with the full size machine, and you just put it in long side in. It's easy. Now, I don't know if anybody else is having this problem, but I haven't changed any plates. These are the same ones I got with the machine, and I haven't used the machine a ton. I have used it quite a bit, but I wouldn't say a ton. And my issue is that this magnetic plate is stretching out. I think I'm gonna have to get a new one. I have got one additional of the clear acrylic plates so that when I do have to change one of them, I'll be ready. Now, this is a couple days later, and I forgot which marker I used for the color. And so I just pulled the one I thought it was. It was wrong. So it's a little bit off. But I do use the Tim Holtz Distress ink again on it. And you'll see that in just a minute. This adhesive foam is really nice. It's also from Scrapbooking Made Simple. I really like Scrapbooking Made Simple. They have really great prices, but it takes forever to get anything from there. So you can always just get some fun foam and put it through your Xyron. That'd be kind of my recommendation. It'd do the same thing. So, here I'm just adding a little bit of old paper. You can do it, you cannot do it. I just really wanted it to look like old paper. So I was like, I'll add a little bit. Now I'm giving some foam tape to this one as well. And I didn't end up actually using the vellum piece because it was too clean looking. And I'm taking some permanent adhesive runner. I haven't found one that I'm just in love with. So every time I try and buy a different one. Thank you so much for joining me. If you try this technique, please link me in Instagram or Facebook. I would love to see what you guys create. Anyway, here's two other videos you may like, or you can go to my channel, like and subscribe, and have a wonderful day.